One of the easiest constellations to find during the winter season in the northern hemisphere is Auriga, and this is because it has this distinctive pattern in the sky and this bright yellow star called Capella. And in this video, we will take a closer look at Capella, which is actually a quadruple star system, along with getting some practice on recognizing this constellation. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. Even though Capella appears to be a single star to the naked eye, it's actually a quadruple system that is made up of two binary pairs, including two yellow giant stars and two red dwarf companions. Capella is estimated to be 42.9 light years away, and the name Capella means little goat in Latin. It's the sixth brightest star in the night sky, however, it's the third brightest in the northern hemisphere. And as you're looking at this picture, here is the shape that I see when I see Auriga. I see the pentagon shape, and those are the five stars that stand out to me, but Capella is the brightest one. So let's dive in a little bit deeper to this star system. So the two main stars are yellow giant stars. What does this mean? It means that they burned through their hydrogen and now they're starting to move off the main sequence band. They are estimated to orbit each other every 104 days. And they're much bigger than the sun in the sense. Let's get in a picture, an idea of how big they are compared to the sun. They're about 2.5 times the mass of our own sun. So if this were a picture of our sun, here is a size comparison of Capella AA and AB. These are the two main yellow giant binary stars. And then the other red dwarfs here are dubbed Capella H and Capella L. And if we were to get another visual, right here is where they are. And this second pair is much farther away than these two are. It's estimated these are 10,000 astronomical units from the two main binary stars. So it's interesting that when you're actually looking at Capella, this is a quadruple star system. So in the next portion of this video, we're going to get some practice with how to find Capella in the sky. Now let's get some practice with how to identify Auriga and its bright star Capella in the sky. So here we have a celestial map of what Auriga looks like. And I do have a whole separate video about this constellation and the celestial objects that are located within this constellation. So be sure to go see that video. But we're going to focus on Capella and being able to find this yellow giant star system. So when I look at Auriga, the constellation, I often see the pentagon shape. But it's supposed to represent a goat herder. And here you can see maybe perhaps this is its head with a little hat. This is his eye and this is his nose. So I'm just guessing at that. I know different cultures from around the world will see different patterns. But here we have a easy to find picture of Auriga. And this is definitely a very beautiful picture to see, but not typically what you would see if you're going to be in an area with lots of light pollution. This is a long exposure photograph, so that allows some of the stars of the background to shine through. So here is the pattern of Auriga, and this is where Capella is. Notice that as you're looking at this picture here of Capella, there's three bright stars here, and it's kind of a red, white, and blue color. So I often look for this little triangular pattern right next to Capella. Let's take a look at another picture. As you're looking at this photo, there's three main constellations, and Capella is the brightest star of this photograph, so right over here. And if we were to point out the different constellations in this photograph, we have Auriga, which is connected to Taurus right there. We have this pattern of Gemini, and this is Canis Minor. Let's keep getting some more practice. Here again is this picture, and we see, this is kind of what I see when I look at Auriga. These five stars are the one that stands out, but it does share a star with the constellation Taurus. It's not common for constellations to share a star, but this is one of them. So here are the horns of Taurus, and this is Aldebaran, the bright star within the constellation Taurus. And then here's the other here's what the official star pattern is, but that's not kind of what I see. I was always grown up and taught that this was the star pattern, but in fact, it does look like this. So I hope this video is helpful for you, just to help you identify what Auriga looks like in the sky, and that when you're looking at Capella, you're looking at a quadruple star system. I do have one more shot here. This shows you a good portion of the winter night sky during the winter season in the northern hemisphere. And here you can see this is where Orion is. And you can use Orion to help you find Auriga. And that's the brightest star right there. So it's right at the tippy top. But use Orion to help you find all the other constellations in the sky. Capella is also a part of the asterism known as the winter hexagon, and the winter hexagon is another asterism that can be seen during the winter months in the northern hemisphere, and it's a very large asterism that connects the six brightest stars of all these different constellations in the winter sky, and it can be a challenge to point this out simply because the asterism is so large in the sky. So here are the main stars that are part of the winter hexagon, and if we were to point those out, here is where Capella is, and then it connects with Aldebaran, Rigel, Sirius, Procyon, and Pollux of Gemini. And if we were to point out which constellations are connected with each of these stars, this is what that would look like. So again, our focus for this video is Capella. It's a part of the constellation Auriga. And again, it's connected to Taurus by one star right there. Then we have Orion, Canis Major, Canis Minor, and finally Gemini. This concludes our video about Capella, the brightest star in the constellation known as Auriga. Auriga is one of the easiest constellations to me to point out, and most of that is because of Capella. It's this bright yellow star that really stands out compared to the rest of the stars. And I've got another picture here. Here we have Auriga, Gemini, and Canis Minor. And you can easily see that Capella is the brightest star. And every time you look at this star system, you're actually looking at a quadruple star system. You have the two yellow giant stars that are circling each other every 104 days, and they've run out of hydrogen. They're now burning helium, and they've grown in size when compared to our own sun. And don't forget, there's also two red dwarfs that are a part of this star system as well. Red dwarf stars are some of the most common that are out there. They're just not always easy to see because they're so small, therefore they're dim. But Capella is a quadruple star system, and it is such a beautiful constellation. I simply love this photo. You can see how bright Capella is. You can see the red, white, and blue star triangle pattern right underneath it. And some of the celestial objects are also coming through in this photograph as well. So remember, as you go outside, it takes time, patience, and practice. I, of course, encourage you to escape light pollution. Try to see the stars with really, really dark skies. That's when you'll be able to see the star patterns come through. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, keep looking up.